Yes, class. Good morning. Today's topic is problem solving exercise 6.1. And in this exercise, the second lecture. Today I'm taking the question number 10. This question is very, very important because this question many times came in the board exam. Now, read the question here. A ladder is 5 meter long, is leaning against a wall. The bottom of the ladder is pulled along the ground away from the wall at the rate of 2 meter per second. How fast is its height on the wall decreasing when the foot of the ladder is 4 meter away from the wall? First, read the question very carefully. Then, what things is given? What things you find here? Then now discuss about the question here. Means question here, wall, ladder, the position of the ladder is hypotenuse shape, position of the wall is height shape. So means in this shape here, this is the wall, height of the wall, and this is the ladder. Suppose this is a PQ, here ladder, and here PQR. This is the ladder 5 meter, and this is the wall. This is the length of Y, and I am taking this is the X. This is the right angle triangle. Given condition here, this is the height of the wall is Y. Distance between the bottom of the ladder and bottom of the wall is X. A length of the ladder is 5 meter. After some time, this condition is changing. What changing here? Means this ladder pulled here, this ladder pulled from bottom side along the ground, pulled along the ground, then this distance will be converted in 4 meter, this converted in the 4 meter. When you pull the ladder and pull here along the ground, then come this position, the ladder will be this position converted in this position. So how, in which rate fall the ladder? In which rate fall the ladder means which rate? dy over dt. You will be find here. And this is length of the y also. This is the wall. When you pull your ladder from this side, this distance converted in x distance converted in 4 meter. And this ladder p convert change position of the p dash. When this position fall, P position fall, P dash. In which rate this will be fall? In which rate this will be fall, you will be find here. And this value of the X here means rate of the pull here, 2 cm per second. Here, right? Along the ground, away from the wall, at the rate 2 cm per second. When you pull the ladder here, in which rate? 2 cm per second. So now, what things are given right here? Now start the solution here. Given things. First, dx over dt. 2 cm per second. First. Second things, value of the x in converted in 4 meter and x equal 4 meter. Second things, this is the right angle triangle, the in triangle PQR. Using Pythagoras theorem, x square plus y square plus 5 square. The height of the base plus height of the square equal the height of the hypotenuse. X square plus y square equal to 25. This is the equation first. Now, this converted the equation first. When you putting the value of x here, then you will get value of the y. X square plus y square equal to 25 to y square equal to 25 minus 16 to y equal root 9 to y equal 3. Then value of when putting the value of the x here 4, then we get value of the y here 3. Next. Now again differentiate of if you differentiate of the equation first, now from equation first differentiate with respect to time. Here second time here. So now from the differentiate equation first with respect to time t. So what will you come here? D over dt x square plus y square equal d over dt 25. Here differentiate here to 2x. Now differentiate variable is x with respect of the t, then you will again differentiate of it dx over dt here. Plus similarly here 2y, again dy over dt, or this is the constant number, then result will be 0. Differentiation of the constant number here 0. Now 2y dy over dt equal to minus 2x dx over dt. This will be transposing the right side. Now putting the value of y, x and dx over dt. Dx over dt, x and dy over dt. Now this will be cancelled here. So value of the y here 3 dy over dt, value of the x here 4 and into dx over dt is 2, then dy over dt equal to minus 8y3. This answer here come 8y3. Now dy over dt, y is the length, t is the time, then you will write here centimeter, meter per second, because length here given, sorry, centimeter per second here, dx over dt already given here, centimeter per second, then centimeter per second. This is called 8/3, the rate of the falling of the ladder, falling of the wall with by the wall, by the ladder, this -8/3. This is your answer. So very simple thing here. Without first you read the question carefully, then you write what things given. Now you using the Pythagoras theorem here, then putting value and calculate and find the answer last. This is very simple and very important question. This, yes, no doubt. Yes, students, next question, I am taking the different type question here, because this is question number 11. Question number 11, now read here. A particle move along the curve we are given, find the points on the curve at which y coordinate is changing 8 times fast as the x coordinate. Now, first read the question carefully here and understand. Here f given condition here x and y, and x and y we are moving with respect of the time, not any other parameter given here. So this will be changing, x move to moving relation will come in the with respect of the time t. So now what things are given, then note down here. First solution given things. Curves 6y equal x cube plus 2. This is the curve first we are given. Second thing, coordinate rate change of x and y. X and y coordinate with respect to time t. दे आर मूविंग देन विद दे एक्शन वाई रेट चेंज ऑफ एक्शन वाई कोऑर्डिनेट विद रिस्पेक्ट टाइम टी देन डी एक्स ओवर डी टी एंड डी वाई ओवर डी टी. सेकेंड थिंग्स गिवन कंडीशन the curve at which the y coordinate is changing 8 times as fast of the x coordinate means relation between what relation given x and y coordinate here means this is the given relation given here dy over dt is equal to 8 times of dx over dt. This is equation number second. This relation between both the moving particles here and on the coordinate axis, the dy over dt equal to a times dx over dt. So now, taking the first equation and differentiate here, now from first. Here, solution start here. Now from first. These things are given, then start solution from here. From 6y equal x cube plus 2, differentiate with respect to time t, time t, the dy over dt, 6y equal d over dt x cube plus 2. Differentiate here 6, dy over dt equal 3x square. Differentiate x cube first here, differentiate x cube here first, 3x square, again differentiate here x. So this will be dx over dt. Are here, for this is a constant, this will be 0. This is a constant, then the result will be 0. So now putting here dy over dt here, the dy over value of dy over dt here. So now 6 into 8 dx over dt equal 3x square dx over dt using first, using equation second. This will be cancelled here. What is left? 3x square equal to 48 and x square equal to 16. Then x equal to root 16 and x equal to plus minus 4. The value of the x equal to plus minus 4. And what you find here? Find the points on the curve. You will find the points. So the value of the x already you find here. Then find the value of the y. Then putting the value in equation first, you get the value of the y. So now from first, x equal to 4, then 6y equal 4 cube plus 2. So y equal 4 plus 16, 64. 64 plus 2. So y equals 64, 66 by 6. This will become 11. The value of the y is equal to 11. When x equal to, then coordinate will become here. XY coordinate will become here 4. 11 and when x equal to minus 4, second value here coming two values plus minus. I'm first positive value I'm taking here or negative value I'm taking here. The when x equal to minus 4, then the 6y equal minus 4 cube plus 2, y equals 64 minus 64 plus 2 upon 6, the result will become here 62 upon 6. So y equal minus 31 upon cancel by 2, 3. When you cancel by divide by 2, then 2 3 ja and 2 31 ja. So then this will become here 31. The required point coordinate of xy here. What coordinate here? When minus 4, then come here minus 31 upon 3. This is the required coordinate. So now, hence the required coordinate, required points on the curve. First is 4, 11, and second here -4, -31/3. This is your answer. This is a very simple thing here. First, you read the question carefully. What things given you right here? These four steps you are given from here to here. Net solution, mostly solution start from here. 6y equal to, then differentiate this equation first and putting the given condition here, find the value of the x. So value of the x here 2 ± 4. Then using this plus minus 4 in equation first, then value find the y. When putting value of plus positive value, then getting you the 11. When putting the minus value of the x, then getting the minus value of the y. The required point of, this is your required point. Means I am writing here, this is your final answer. Very, very important questions, not down. Yes, class. Next question, I am taking the very, very important question. Question number 14 from NCERT book. Question here, sand is pouring from a pipe at the rate of 12 cm cube per second. The falling sand form a cone on the ground in such a way that the height of the cone is always 1/6 of the radius of the base. How fast is the height of the sand cone increasing when the height of is 4 cm? First, read the question 2 times, 3 times very carefully, then understand the question, what things given and what is requirement to find the answer. What thing requirement to find the answer? So here things, sand is poured with help of the pipe and volume of the sand here given 12 cm cube per second is in this range. This volume of the rate of the volume of this sand here given. Second is falling sand cone of form of a cone. Means suppose you are throwing in this pipe. This is the pipe. Suppose this is the pipe. Pipe is not thrown here, only pouring with help of the pipe. You are throwing the sand from here and this sand will be converted in the form of a cone. This sand, when put in ground, then convert of heap of the cone form, in this form. Sand come and convert in this form here. This sand is poured from a pipe, in this pipe, and rate of the total volume of the sand is 12 cm of rate of this. And the falling sand form of a cone, this is a cone form. And always 1/6, and this is the height of the cone. This is the radius of the cone, R, and this is the height of the cone. This is the height of the cone. And what things given here? Solution start from here. What things given? First things here given. Falling rate of the sand, any dB over dT, volume. You are right, centimeter cube means dB over dT. dB over dT, because you are respect of the second. So dB over dT are given 12 cm cube per second. Clear things? Second, next thing you are given. In a way, so the height of the cone is always 1/6. And height of the cone here adds 1/6 of the radius of the base. This is a circle and radius of the base here this. The 1/6 of this means R equals 6H. Two things here given. Next. And what you find here? How fast height of the sand cone increasing? Means you will find here K कि डी एच ओवर डी टी इन व्हेन हाइट ऑफ द सैंड इज 4 सेंटीमीटर व्हेन एच और ऑल्सो यू आर गिवन एच इक्वल टू 4 सेंटीमीटर व्हेन एच इक्वल टू 4 सेंटीमीटर व्हाट इज द रेट ऑफ दिस देन यू विल फाइंड दिस एच इज गिवन पर व्हाट इन विच रेट विल बी हाइट इंक्रीजिंग इन विच रेट ऑफ द हाइट इंक्रीजिंग व्हेन एच 4 सेंटीमीटर देन यू विल फाइंड दिस नाउ वॉल्यूम ऑफ द कोन हियर एवरीथिंग इन रिलेशन ऑफ द कोन वॉल्यूम ऑफ द कोन वॉल्यूम ऑफ द कोन इक्वल टू 1/3 πr² मीन्स वी इक्वल 1/3 πr² नाउ और वॉल्यूम ऑफ द कोन डिफरेंशिएट विद रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ द टाइम टी तो नाउ डिफरेंशिएट डिफरेंशिएट इक्वेशन फर्स्ट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू टाइम टी बिकॉज यू आर गिवन 12 cm³/s यू आर गिवन हिट हियर देन विद रिस्पेक्ट टू टाइम टी dv over dt equal 1/3 πr is the constant here and π/3 are constant and d over dt r square h then you can differentiate here are putting the value of r square what value of the r here 6h then π/3 will write here same π/3 and d over dt what value are 6h so 6h square into h so π/3 d over dt and 36 h³ h square into h 6 is 36 and h square into h³ what value come here 36 π/3 then d over dt into h³ only you will differentiate only h³ here so what will you come here 12 solve your 12 and 3h² / dh/dt because here we are differentiating with respect of the t the 3h² h³ means 3h² and again differentiated h to dh/dt then here came here dv/dt our value of dv over dt are given 12 this is given here 12 so then 12 pi 3h² and dh/dt so 12 by 12 by cancel here this is come here 1 here the dh/dt upon 1 upon 3 πh² come in the right side this upon this numerator come denominator here so what value of the h here putting the value of the h here given so dh/dt at h equal to 4 what value given here 1 upon 3 pi at h here 4 h² what value come here 4 for the 16 is 48 pi So this is the dh/dt h equal 4 the dh/dt h equal 4 1 upon 48 pi or what is the unit here h is the height this will be centimeter already given here centimeter so this will become centimeter per time here per second the height of increasing rate of this height when h equal to 4 when height is 4 cm in which rate will be increasing this will be increasing at the 1/48 πc² in which rate will be height will be increased in this rate this is the rate of the increasing of the height when height is 4 cm this is your final answer the rate of you can write the answer here hence in rate of the increasing of the height here 1/48 pi centimeter. This you note down. So very very simple thing and importance. First, what is given here? Then you write here. Then write the volume of the cone. This formula. But here putting the value of the r. R value I am converting. Value putting here r. Then I am putting the value of r 6h. Then solve and get the answer. Then you will find the large dh over dt. Dh over dt means rate of the height. Dh over increasing rate of the height. Increasing rate of the height. Clear? Just note down. This is a very very important question. Yes, students. Next question I am taking the question number 16. This is the different type questions. Yes, now read the question here. The total revenue in rupees received from the sale of X units of a product is given by total revenue here. Write in the equation form, algebraic equation form here, not write in the directly rupees form. This is a total rupees, but write this total rupees, not write here in amount form. This is the right equation form. Find the marginal revenue when x equal to 7. First, understand the question. This is a different type question. First things, what is the marginal revenue or total revenue? Suppose you are sold anything, then you get the money. This is told the total revenue. Revenue means you get the money, yes, total revenue. And how many units are sold? This is the X units. How many? Any product, how many units are sold? Your X unit, any product is sold. Then you get the total amount. This is the total amount you are getting this. After sold in these units, then you get the total amount of this. 13x square plus 26 plus 15. You get the total amount of this. So then what you find here? Find the marginal revenue of the when x equal to 7. Suppose you are selling the 7 units, any product, then what is the marginal revenue? Suppose you are selling the 7 units, then what is the marginal revenue? The first thing, marginal revenue kya hai? Then start the question here, solution. What things given here first? Total revenue. Total revenue is called, total. Total revenue Rx is called here 13x square plus 26x plus 15. Now what you find here? Marginal revenue. You will find here marginal revenue when number of when x equals 7 units. What is the marginal revenue when you are sold 7 units of this product? First thing, what is the marginal revenue? Marginal revenue here is dr over dx. Marginal revenue equal rate change of the total revenue. Marginal revenue, definition of the marginal revenue, rate change of the total revenue with respect to number of units sold. Then you look here. Marginal revenue equal dr upon dx. What do you mean dr here? Meaning of dr, the rate change of the total revenue with respect of number of units sold x. How many units are sold here? X. The dx means number of units are sold with respect to number unit of sold. Now the marginal revenue equal d over dx. What value of the r here? Total rx 13x square plus 26x plus 15. Now differentiate with respect to this 26x square, 26x plus 26. Why you differentiate in this 13 with the 26? This x are here only 26. So this is the dr over dx means marginal revenue. Our margin revenue you will find here when x equal to 7 units. This is the unit, not its unit. When x equal to 7 means dr over dx, x equal 7 units, then 26 into 7 plus 26, मल्टीप्लाई है 7 6 42 एंड 7 2 14 एंड 4 18 प्लस 26। नाउ एड यर 200 मीन्स डी आर ओवर डी एक्स एट एक्स इक्वल टू 7 रिजल्ट यू गेट 208 मीन्स मार्जिनल रिवेन्यू। मार्जिनल रिवेन्यू मीन्स रेट चेंज ऑफ टोटल रिवेन्यू विद रिस्पेक्ट नंबर ऑफ यूनिट सोल्ड इज यू गेट 208। दिस इज यू विल गेट द ₹208। दिस इज कम अमाउंट फॉर्म। दिस इज कम 208 अमाउंट 208 रुपीज। दिस इज योर आंसर। दिस क्वेश्चन लुकिंग वेरी when you look this and read it, this is difficult, but not question is not difficult, question is very very easier, but you understand the question, what things given, what you find here, what is the identity here, what you find here, the marginal revenue here, the definition of the marginal revenue is rate change of the total revenue with respect of number of units sold, x, y, z, anything so, then you get an calculate and find the answer. Yeah, this is your answer. Note down and then start the next topic.